Myself, Shailesha Patwari, welcomes to all of you in this important and valuable session. Basically, my motive is to people understand properly what is Android. So I'm making this presentation during my training period from pure CSS. So these are the contents we will study in this presentation. So first question is, what is Android? So what is Android? Android is an open source and Linux-based operating system for mobile devices such as smartphones and tablet computers. Android was developed by the Open Handset Alliance led by Google and other companies. So basically, it is a Linux-based operating system for your mobile devices such as smartphones, tablet and computers, and is led by Google and developed by Open Handset Alliance. And it is unified approach to develop applications, and it is similar to Java programming language, and it is developed in the year of 2008, month September, and date is 23. Next is, this consists of three things: Linux kernel, operating system version 3.6, and second one is middleware, a set of libraries provided by Google. So middleware, what is middleware? Middleware is a software which lies between operating system and the application running on it. Key applications, third one is key applications, that is Instagram, Facebook, Gmail, Twitter, YouTube, which you are using in your daily basics. It is a social media platform. So why we prefer Android? First one is open source. Open source means it is free. Everyone can use it. Very easy to use. And second one is larger developer and community reach. Third one is increased marketing. It increases the market level. Fourth, inter-app integration. Fifth, reduce cost of development. Next, higher success ratio. And last one is rich development environment. Now we will study about features of environment and their description. First one is beautiful user interface. In this Android operating system, basic screen provides a beautiful and intuitive user interface. It provides a beautiful screen for the user to design various types of application programs, and its connectivity with Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and etc. Media support, you can see images in it, download music and movies, and etc. And you can communicate with through messages and videos, etc. You can you also use these types of platforms in your daily basis. Fifth one is multitasking. User can jump from one task to another, and same time various applications can run simultaneously. For example, you are using Instagram and you want to use YouTube also. So you can switch from Instagram to YouTube as well. So last one is GCM. GCM is messaging is a service that lets developers send short message data to users on Android devices without any syncing. You don't need any syncing. So you can send this short message to the users on their Android devices. Next is Android application. Android applications are usually developed in the Java language using the Android software development kit. Next, once developed Android applications can be packaged easily and sold out either through a store such as Google Play. Everyone knows about Play Store. So once you develop any application on Android Studio, currently we are using Android Studio for making application programs. So before you make application programs, after that you will package easily it and sold out it where Play Store or any Opera mobile store or anywhere you want to sold out your application programs, and everyone can download it from Play Stores and these social media platforms. Next is categories of applications. Categories of applications, kis kis categories mein applications use hote hain. Music, news, multimedia, these are the things you use in your daily basics, like social media, finance, navigation is for maps, maps use for where you want to go, travel, weather you see, and food and drink, whatever is it. So history of Android, the code names of Android, these are the past versions of Android. I'm using Android 9, that is Pi. So you are using your Android versions in your phones. You have also read about that Marshmallow, Android 6.0, Android 5.0, Lollipop. So these are the versions, past versions of Android. Next is, what is API level? An application program interface is set of routines, protocols, and tools for building software application. This is the tool to build a software application. Basically, an API specifies how software components should interact. Additionally, APIs are used when programming graphical user face interface components. So these are the platform versions with their API level and version code. Currently, Android is Android 10.0 and its API level is 29, and is led by Google, and version code is KitKat. Next is Android environment setup. So environment setup is to build applications, and second one is SDK, that is software development kit, which is used to create softwares, various types of softwares. Third one is Java development kit, and next is and it is very compatible with Android, Mac, and operating and various operating systems. Next is third point is that all the required tools to develop Android applications are freely available. As we read about, that is very free available for you, and you can download from the web. And as I told you, we are currently using Android Studio, and in Android Studio, you can make any type of application programs and upload it anywhere like Play Store, Google Play, Amazon, everything, etc. So it is very free available, and you can download from any from the web. Here, last two components are optional, and if you are working on Windows machine, then these components make your life easy while doing Java-based application development. So let us have a look how to proceed to set required environment. These are the two components to make your life easy while doing Java based application development. First one is set up Java development kit, JDK, and second one is Android IDEs. IDEs means development environment, integrated development environment. So next is Android application components. Application components are the essential building blocks of an Android application. These components are loosely coupled by the application manifest file, androidmanifest.xml, that describes each component of the application, that how they interact. Basically, this slide is to how the user interact with the issues or any other making during making application programs. Kya kya usko issues handle karne padte hain. They are following four main components that can be issued with any Android application. Activity, they dictate the user interface. ID, it handles the user interaction to the smartphone screen. Second one is the handle background processing associated with an application. Third one is it the handle communication between Android operating system and other applications. And the fourth one is they handle data and database management issues. So, जो आपका डेटा होता है वो डेटाबेस में सेव होता है, उसके बाद जो भी आपके एप्लीकेशन में इश्यूज वगैरह आते हैं उसको चेक करता है, उसके मतलब इंटरेक्ट करता है कि एप्लीकेशन और उस यूजर और ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम के बीच का जो इंटरेक्शन होता है उस चीज को, ये उस चीज के इश्यूज को देखता है. नेक्स्ट वाज द एडिशनल कंपोनेंट्स. फ्रेगमेंट्स रिप्रेजेंट अ पोर्शन ऑफ यूजर इंटरफेस इन एन एक्टिविटी. Views that are drawn on screen, including buttons, list, forms, etc. You can मतलब screen पे कोई भी buttons, list, forms, कुछ भी design create करके आप कुछ भी तरीके का application form कर सकते हो, layouts ले सकते हो. Android Studio में I will show Android Studio how it's look like. Now there I will show you layouts. एक palette होता है, वहाँ पे palette में से आप कुछ भी buttons, text view, कुछ भी ला के आप अपना application program को design कर सकते हो किसी भी तरीके से. Intense messaging wire components together. This is how Android Studio looks like. Front page ये है, where you can start a new project in import also, and you can see the mobile on the screen. This is emulator where you can run the application without any, you know, दो तरीके से आप अपने applications को run कर सकते हो, एक अपने phone पर और एक ऐसे emulator पर. अपने phone पर आप USB debugging से application को run कर सकते हो. Second one is emulator से आप run कर सकते हो. Next is anatomy of Android applications. So before you run your app, you should be aware of few directories and files in the Android projects. So these are ये कुछ चीजें हैं जो Android को मतलब app को run करने से पहले आप इन चीजों को कुछ पता होना चाहिए, तो हम इसके नेक्स्ट स्लाइड में इसके बारे में पढ़ते हैं. जावा, दिस कंटेन्स द जावा सोर्स फाइल फॉर योर प्रोजेक्ट, बाय डिफॉल्ट इंक्लूड एंड मेन एक्टिविटी डॉट जावा सोर्स फाइल हैविंग एन एक्टिविटी क्लास दैट रन्स योर व्हेन योर ऐप इज लॉन्च यूजिंग ऐप आइकन. ये आपके ऐप को रन करता है जब आपका आपके ऐप को लॉन्च होने से पहले. So next one is resource drawable. This is a directory for drawable object that are designed for high density screens. ये एक drawable objects मतलब आप अपने एक applications को कैसे भी किसी भी तरीके से design कर सकते हैं. Resource layout. This is a directory for files that defines your app user interface. Next one is resource value. This is a directory for other various XML files that contain a collection of resources such as strings and color definitions. Color, strings, कुछ भी आप code के जरिए उस applications में import कर सकते हैं. Build Gradle. This is an auto-generated file which contains compile SDK version, build tools version, application ID. वर्जन कोड एंड वर्जन नेम. बिल्ड ग्रेडल मतलब कि आप ना मतलब किसी भी एंड्रॉयड वर्जन में किसी भी एंड्रॉयड में अपना मतलब एक डिवाइस में खाली एंड्रॉयड स्टूडियो में अपना ऐप बनाओगे. द मेन रीजन द मेन बेनिफिट इज कि आपका जो ऐप है वो हर किसी मोबाइल में वर्क करेगा. दिस इज द मेन बेनिफिट. हो प्ले स्टोर पे इतने सारे ऐप्स है, बनाता तो एक ही बंदा है ना, और चलते बहुत सारे डिवाइसेज में है. तो दिस इज द मेन बेनिफिट फॉर दिस. And what is AVD and Android Virtual Device? It is a configuration that defines that characteristics of an Android phone, tablet, wear, and TV. This is a before running your app, you have to install your virtual device. Virtual device means that अगर आपको virtual device install नहीं करना, तो आप अपने phone में run कर सकते हो. As I've said कि आप अपने US debugging से अपना application run कर सकते हो. So that you want to stimulate in the Android emulator. This is the emulator I have said in the previous slide. That emulator is used to run the app. And the AVD manager is an interface you can launch from Android Studio that helps you create and manage AVDs. नेक्स्ट इज हाउ टू क्रिएट अ हेलो वर्ल्ड. सो हेलो वर्ल्ड के लिए आपको पहले एंड्रॉयड स्टूडियो इंस्टॉल करना होता है. इंस्टॉल करने के बाद आपको ये चीज दिखेगी. सो यू हैव टू गो अ स्टार्ट न्यू एंड्रॉयड स्टूडियो प्रोजेक्ट फर्स्ट. नाउ ये सेकेंड है. सेकेंड में यू हैव टू गिव योर एप्लीकेशन नेम. कोई कुछ भी आप अपने एप्लीकेशन का नाम दे सकते हैं यहाँ पे. थर्ड वन इज यू हैव टू चूज हियर योर एंड्रॉयड वर्जन. किस एंड्रॉयड वर्जन में आप अपना एप्लीकेशन जो है वो रन करवाना चाहते हैं. नेक्स्ट वन इज हियर वी सेलेक्ट द ब्लैंक एक्टिविटी. नेक्स्ट वन इज सो ये स्क्रीन वो सब करने के बाद ये स्क्रीन हमें विजिबल होती है. ठीक है. सो आपने मैंने पढ़ाया कि मैनिफेस्ट, जावा, ड्रॉएबल, देखो यहाँ पे सब कुछ चीजें हैं. एंड दिस दीज आर द पैलेट्स. यहाँ पे बटन है, लेआउट है, सब कुछ है यहाँ पे. यहाँ पे आप कुछ भी यूज कर सकते हो अपने एप्लीकेशन को डिजाइन करने के लिए. एंड जो हेलो वर्ल्ड का कोड है वो पहले से लिखा होता है इसके अंदर. सो आपको सिर्फ रन करना होता है और वर्चुअल डिवाइस इंस्टॉल करना होता है इसके अंदर. और वर्चुअल डिवाइस इंस्टॉल करने के बाद ये आपका इम्यूलेटर जो है यहाँ पे ये मोबाइल की तरह माई फर्स्ट एप्लीकेशन हेलो वर्ल्ड यहाँ पे प्रिंट हो जाता है. ठीक है. तो ये था हेलो वर्ल्ड को प्रिंट करवाने का. और थैंक यू. हैव अ सेव एंड नाइस डे सर. डन.